Hello everyone, I'm a male stylist George Steele, and today you will learn how to choose a male suit properly. There are a lot of nuances and rules when you choose a suit, and it's necessary to respect all of them, it's totally worth it. And indeed, a man looks like a real man in a good suit. Today I'm going to demonstrate you some ways to select a right suit, and just Mike will help us. The first one to be mentioned is structure. A suit should be preferably made of 100% wool. Many manufacturers bring too much of it, and that's why there's a sheen on the structure, and it feels like it is just shining, and that's not a good thing. That's why we don't choose a suit like that. Sometimes structure is mixed, and there are wool and silk or wool and mohair. For summer, we can choose a suit of cotton or flax. And what about colors? We choose light colors for weddings and special events. And black is for funeral or if you work as a security. And business-like colors are blue, gray, and dark brown possible as well. There are three types of size depending on height. They are short, regular, and long. If you are shorter than 175 cm, it's better to choose a short type. If you are 175 to 185, it's a regular type. And if you are higher than that, it's better to choose long. Choosing a suit, it is necessary to notice slim fit level. If you see drop 8, then that means that it is the highest level. Drop 7 is suitable for men with a small belly and round shoulders. And drop 4 is for pretty chubby men. The length of the jacket sleeve has to be a bit shorter, about 1 to 1.5 cm than the short sleeve. That would look nice. We button only the highest one when we wear a business-like suit. There a little strange has to be. But there shouldn't be any creases, because your silhouette will be spoiled, and creases will appear in zones of your sleeves and your back. Further, pay attention on the width of the lapel. If it's less than 5 cm and over 10 cm, it looks like you have a fancy pants. It's perfect when the width of the lapel is 35 to 40%, from the beginning of lapel to beginning of the shoulder seam. Also, there's an individual way to choose the width. So, the length of your chin is the width of an appropriate lapel. That's the perfect proportion. And you have to measure the size of the tie knot. The width of the lapel, the tie knot, and your chin should be the same. And also, your lapel has to lay, not to bulge or pucker on your chest. Now let's talk about the pants. Pay attention. If creases appear in your groin area, that means that your pants are not of your size, and you have to choose pants a size bigger or ones with a higher waist. Also, if your legs are beefy, buy pleated front pants, they are more comfortable when you will move. People always ask me, how long pants have to be. That's easy. The skinnier pants are, the shorter they are. If the pants leg is 19 cm in width and less, the button of the pants leg should overlap the beginning of your shoes here. When you buy a suit, you have to finalize it. You may make its waist slimmer in the area of the middle and side seams. The jacket in that case would fit tighter at your back. Let crease often appear in the area of shoulder blades. It is called back neck. Come to a tailor and ask to delete this crease. That's an easy task. You can also change the length of the sleeve, as I've already told. 1 to 1.5 cm of the shirt will be seen under the sleeve of your jacket. You can also make your pants a size bigger or smaller. How? For example, make the waist slimmer with the middle seam. And of course, in the end, don't forget to unseam vents and pockets. A chest pocket and pockets on the waist. The first suit we've analyzed is business-like. And this one is of elegant style. If you want to know the details and differences of these styles, watch the first video of the show «Male Shopping». Subscribe to our channel «Be Bigger», watch the show «Male Shopping» and change for the better.